Hey guys, how's it going? My name is Evac, and I'll be your host for this Gold Challenge Mode dungeon tonight. The dungeon we're doing is Auk. I would give this an easy rating out of easy, medium, or hard. It's definitely one of the more leisure ones as far as time is concerned. The first part, you'll notice there's three groups of mobs. Each group has their own unique ability. The first group has a mob that will MC somebody. The second group has a mob that will shield all of the minions. And the third group has someone that heals as well as void swaps. The way we do this is we pull all three groups, have our druid root the cleric, which is the first group on the right, which is the shielding mob, because we don't want everything to get shielded. I MD him the second group, and as you can see, the cleric is back there getting rooted over and over. This pull was extremely sloppy for us. We should have probably reset it, but we still knew we could finish it with the time we had left. So while the shielding mob is out at range, everybody should be bursting down the MCing mob, which is the Soulbinder. As you can see, our mage got MC'd, so obviously we messed that part up. But we're still able to get through the pull, even though it does take quite a long time. We use all of our cooldowns and trinkets on this pull, and opt to hold Bloodlust for the actual boss. After the majority of the group has been killed, you can pull the cleric out and Zerg it down. Another way to do this, if you don't have roots, is you can also just pull that group on the right by itself, Zerg down the cleric, and then pull everything else. You just really don't want every mob to get a shield. I guess it would be alright if you had a priest with mass dispel, but single dispelling every single mob is quite troublesome and will probably result in a wipe just because nothing will die. We're still bursting down the last two mobs. A good tip is if you want to respec for the actual boss, if you run off of the platform completely and go before the little arc portion of the platform, the little arrow looking thing that my character is next to right now, you can actually get a respec off while the boss RP is happening and you will not get stunned from his falling animation. And then as far as the first boss is concerned, his mechanics are pretty much identical to Heroic. Has his stomp on the ground, which spawns lines that you do not want to stand in, and then all of the other ground effects as well. And he has his shield, which it's nice if you have your group spread out so that when the shield is coming out, it's not stuck in a cluster of lines and ground effects. You can pre-pot as soon as you see the boss flying in the air, right there, and then that's when you pop Bloodlust and whatever remaining cooldowns you have available to you. The boss himself is pretty easy, so I'll let the fight just play out. After the shield comes down, if you have a druid, you can have them pop a cooldown on one of your DPS, probably your highest DPS, or they can use their own personals and they can continue DPSing through the shield. Spamming one person with heals is not too troublesome to get the boss down a little bit quicker. I'm a little late running to the shield, so I just pop deterrence here. Hop behind the shield while the mage continues to do damage. As you can see, our shield was probably in the worst possible position because of all the lines there. This was one of our earlier clears of the instance, so it is a bit sloppy. Mechanics, however, and the tactics stay the same. After this, you want to go back from where you came from as quickly as you can. We pull two groups of mobs here together. The Arbiter is very important that you need to interrupt his cast, the Arbiter's Hammer. What that does is it actually stuns your tank. The only reason you would not want to interrupt it is if you have a DK tank like we do, which can dark sim the cast and cast it on all the mobs, stunning all of them. After that, you probably want to kill the mage, as well as AoE down the rest of the mobs. After this pack has been killed, then you go forward and we pull two more packs. I believe our tank uses his shield wall on this pack right here, and uses Army of the Dead on the last pack. Thank you. You want to stay out of the void zones on the ground. If you do get hit by that, you'll be feared for 10 seconds and it is not dispellable. These two pulls right here aren't too bad as far as damage goes. However, the last pull does a lot of damage. And again, the Arbiter's Hammer you want to keep under control. Only let the ones go through that your tank is able to dark sim if you are running with a DK. Otherwise, you want to interrupt all of them. After this pack is dead, we give our healer a chance to grab some mana for the hardest pack. Here we always cleave off of the mob directly in the middle. His name is the Warden. After everybody's ready, we pull this pack. And again, cleave off of the Warden. Tank needs to use whatever cooldowns they have available. Stay out of the fears on the ground. And the whole group's gonna get gripped in. They do have some melee mechanics as well as the Mage's Arcane Orb, so it's important that if you can get out quickly, you should. You'll see me disengage out of here in just a second. And I'm launching myself towards the next boss so that I can get there a little bit quicker. Once these two mobs are dead, up next is the boss. Mage boss is actually pretty easy. I'll point out what needs to be pointed out in just a moment. I actually switched specs here for more single target damage since there's no adds to worry about killing. If you have melee in your group, as well as for the tank, it's important that you tank her directly in the middle. That way when she spawns a void shell, the melee and the tank can continue attacking. If you have a DK with you, you're able to dark sim either the Mind Spikes or what's better is the Shadow Word Pain. She randomly casts it and it does not have a cast bar, so when your tank has dark sim available, you want to chain interrupt the Mind Blasts so that if she does cast Shadow Word Pain, he gets that. After the AoE damage to the shell is over, go back to DPSing her. This fight's pretty easy. It's similar to the heroic version. Not much different. When she does spawn adds, you don't need to worry about them at all. Just have your tank tank them and just continue focusing her down. Make sure that every time if you have a DK tank, his dark sim is available, that you're chain interrupting these mind spikes. Next part has three or four sets of mobs. First is the Infernal. Then you have the two Pyromancers, a Felguard, four Pyromancers, four or five. The way we do this is our tank runs ahead to the Pyromancers and does dark sim as well as interrupt, maintaining those two mobs. He's able to solo them basically. Don't have to do that, but we have all of our ranged sit on the Infernal. Again, you can switch it up and send a tank and a DPS onto the Pyromancers and have the rest of the DPS just work on this guy. Another way to kill him without having to kite him so far is just to have the druid spam root him. If you do have a druid in your group, that works. All slows and I believe stuns work as well. The reason he got pulled out so far is because he fixated onto me twice in a row, so I just kept backing up while DPSing him. At this point, our tank has pretty much killed both of the Pyromancers, and we will pull the Felguard next. I'm gonna drop him a little bit lower, and then move on to the next pack. He has a frontal cleave, which does a knockback. So you need to make sure your tank is facing him away from their group. Otherwise, everyone will get hit by that. And it does quite a bit of damage to normal DPS and healers. After he's dead, it's very important to have a CC rotation for the group of Pyromancers. We want our tank to hold his AoE grip for the next pull, so we alternate between Shadow Fury, Arcane Torrent, Frag Bombs, all of that. You'll see I get the first Arcane Torrent so that they clump up. We DPS them, get them a little bit lower, and then I believe we're going to have a Shadow Fury happen. After that, we pretty much go off of single interrupts and just try to kill them. It looks like one of them did get off and killed me. After that, we have three groups of two, which are one Felguard, one Pyromancer, three groups of three, which is two Pyromancers, one Felguard per group. For here, we wait till everyone's in position, tank runs directly into the middle, casts his army, and AoE grips everything straight into the middle. After that, we go off of another CC rotation. First one is Shadow Fury. After that, I believe we used a frag bomb, and then there's the tank's arcane torrent. Capacitor totem works very well here if you have a shaman. You can CC them with just about anything, and if you are an engineer, like I say, frag belts and frag bombs do not share cooldown, so they're very nice to use. Basically what that is it's an item that you can attach to your belt, or you can keep in your inventory. You throw a bomb and it incapacitates your target. And it's an AoE effect, so all of the pyromancers get interrupted. Note, it is not a lockout, so they will continue casting immediately after, but it buys you some time to either kill them or line up some more CC. You'll see me running way out of group here, so I can feign death and respec to my single target spec again. Nowadays, you'll see me playing BM through all of the dungeons and bosses, just because as long as you line up your cooldowns properly as a hunter, you can still do sufficient damage. I did get pulled back into combat, so I have to respec again. Here I make the group wait for me so that I can get the feast, and then I rejoin them. This boss again, it's very important that when he phases, you have that phase controlled very well. We do use Bloodlust on this boss just to get him down as quickly as we can. Our druid pops hard of the wild and does as much damage as he can as well. The debuff he puts out is basically a ticking AoE, and if anyone is near you, it will pass onto them as well. So whoever gets that just needs to stand out of their group and get healed. As soon as he jumps in the air, you'll have meteors coming from the sky, spawning little limps, pyromancers, as well as one Felguard. The Felguard just needs to be tanked, and try to CC the pyroblasting adds as well as you can. I believe here, if you have a warlock, it's very strong because they can banish one as well as enslave one. You'll see me trying to look for one to trap, but it looks like they're all taken care of. As soon as the boss lands, you go back immediately on him. He should be quite low at this point if you also use Bloodlust. Completely optional, but we just like to get it down as quickly as we can because the last boss is pretty simple. One thing that is very important is when the boss dies, that debuff will still continue ticking. So whoever has it, you need to make sure they do not follow the rest of you onto that portal, because if you all clump up, one tick of that will pass it on to every single player. And that's quite a lot of damage. Next up, we have the three mini bosses. The little imp can again be banished if you have a warlock. If not, make sure you interrupt Cauterize Master, because that will heal the actual mini-boss, and you don't want that. It takes longer to kill. The Chaos Wave can either be jumped over or sidestepped. You'll see our mage fail the jump over there. Again, all of this boss's abilities are Dark Simmable if you do have DKs with you. Good cast to get here is the Shadow Bolt. The only other cast he has is Grimmer of Servitude, which spawns another add. It's interruptible. With this mini boss, he has his Wraith Guard with him, which has two abilities. One is a knockback, one is a blade storm. He is stunnable, so as soon as you see him casting a Blade Storm, it's important to either stun him, incapacitate him, or move away. You see the first stun we have there is Shadow Fury. The boss casts Drain Life, that's also very important to interrupt because he heals the mini-boss. Another strategy you can use is if you have a druid with you. We did not do it here, but you can also root that mob and move the mini-boss away from it into a different corner, and he will just stand still and Blade Storm over the corner. We didn't use a stun on that second Blade Storm just because it wasn't really necessary. As soon as this Warlock dies, you'll move on to the final one. He will sack his pet, and as soon as you pull him and start casting Immolates as well as Incinerates, Dark Simming and Immolate here helps quite a bit because it puts a ticking dot on him. Obviously want to move out of the Rain of Fire and AoE him so he moves out of you. I'm dying here intentionally so that I have Bloodlust for the last boss. Since we have a Druid, a Warlock, and a Death Knight, we have plenty of battle reses. As soon as this mob dies, all that's left is the last boss. It is good to note that this instance is a bit buggy in that the mob count is not accurate, and killing the last boss will complete your mob count if you're missing two. Okay, so this boss has a few different mechanics. They're all similar to Heroic again. He casts Doom on a player. When that explodes, you want to make sure you're not near anybody. He spawns the Infernal, which we just chain root, like I mentioned you could earlier. You can also slow it and stun it as well. After he flies in the air and comes back down, he'll start casting Chaos Bolts. If you do not have a DK with you, you need to interrupt them. Otherwise, you can Dark Sim them. Depending on who it's on, they might be able to survive it. DKs can AMS, the Hunter is able to deter, Mage can Ice Block. The only person in the group that would die if they got casted on would be the Druid, in which case we would interrupt the cast. Shamans can also ground that, and you still get the Dark Sim from it. After that, you drop him down to about 20% or so, and he flies in the air, and 7 seconds after that, you will get the achievement for gold, or dungeon completion. This has been my guide for Akhenduin Gold Challenge Mode. If you have any questions, please feel free to leave them in the comments, or come by the Twitch channel and ask. I'll leave a few links below for you guys. This video is brought to you by www.challengeden.com. Thank you so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed.